Hello everyone, welcome to Language Studios. My name is Sai Bhosle. In this video, we will take a look on how to flash AOSP Android 11 on the emulator. So let's get started. So previously, I made a video on AOSP where we have downloaded and built the source code. Now to flash the operating system onto an emulator, we first have to initialize the environment. So this is the command which we will be using for initializing the environment. So just copy this and make sure that you are inside the AOSP folder and then paste this command. Then we have to choose the target device on which we will be flashing the AOSP using the launch command. Now here we have a bunch of devices for which we can build and flash the operating system. Now let me tell you something, the first two options are for ARM devices. So if you want to flash AOSP on ARM devices, then you will select any one of those options depending upon whether the device is 32-bit or 64-bit. Now I tried building the Android 11 by selecting these two options and the build was successful. But when I was trying to flash or eat on the emulator, then at that point of time, the screen just showed the Android logo and the screen got freezed up and the operating system didn't boot up. So use only these options if you want to flash AOSP on a physical device, physical ARM-based device, and not on the emulator. But if you want to flash AOSP on the emulator, you better select these two options. Which are AOSP x86 ENG and x86-64 ENG. So these are the first one is the 32-bit and the second one is the 64-bit options, as this will work perfectly fine and you will also not face any errors while flashing AOSP Android 11. I also tried to build the Fuchsia OS, but during building only I was facing some errors. So I just left that out and just focused on the Android x86 and 64-bit options. So here we will be selecting the option number 30, which is the AOSP x86 64-bit. So we will type in here 30. After selecting the target option, we then build the source code. So to build the source code, we use the command M, which stands for make, and J-8. So 8 is the number of cores which we'll be using in this operation. So you can use any number of cores depending upon how much core your system supports. So this build step is optional. You don't have to execute this command every time. Only for the first time we have to run this command, and then whenever you make any changes to the source code, then only you have to execute this command. I have already built the operating system for Android x86, so I will not build it again. So the output files of this operation will be present inside this directory. So if we go inside Android 11, then you can go inside output, target, product. So this is the output folder which you get. Now after that, we have to run this on the emulator. The emulator is already present inside the source code. So we just have to run the emulator command, which will flash the AOSP on that emulator. So if you scroll down in the documentation, here you will find this command. So just copy it and paste it here. This will take some time. So whenever you will open a new terminal window, every time you have to run these three commands. So the first command is the build command. Then the second command is the launch command, using which you have to select the target device. you always have to select the target device whenever you run a new terminal. Then this is the optional step, building. You only have to run this only a single time. And if you made any changes, then only you run this command. And the third command is the emulator. You have to run this command at the end, whenever you want to flash it on the emulator. So finally, we have flashed the USB on the emulator. So if you go to settings, and then you go to about emulator, and here you can see it is USB on x86 64 bit. So we have finally flashed the USB on the emulator. If you want to understand the directory structure of the USB project, then you can read this answer at Stack Overflow. So I will also provide the link of this in the description section so you can read. So it has explained each and everything. And thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, then subscribe to our channel, and I will catch you up in the next video.